open in my black. There it is.
Ma'am.
Thank you. All right. Here we have a drop loin. We cut off, just drop it off. The flank is still attached. All the kidney fat is still on here, the adipose fat. All the cod fat is still on here. The flank is sitting right here, flank steak. First thing we're going to do is when we come in, we're going to take the flank steak out. I believe it's called cod fat. Let's see how much time we have, okay? I ran really short on my last one.
Cooking, it's not even in the market. Okay.
in the retail, you can't do it. But that was one of the uses we had for it.
It's good use.
And a nice, clean, white fat like that, there's a lot of uses for this, especially in the sausage industry. This is just some of the stuff that I keep on hand if I ever get it. That's beautiful stuff. Right? Nothing wrong with that. This membrane here, this yellowish material, you definitely don't want that in there. Because that's like elastic.
Yeah, looks exactly like water.
Think about it, it's a lot cleaner if I don't.
Yeah.
I mean, if I don't do anything, there's never going to be an issue. If I start buying stuff here, then I'll be selling it at the store, buying it from us for no profit, and selling it. No store sales.
But what I can do here, within the world of the school, I can take some of this trim, stuff that's just going to become trim, and I can turn it into something, send it to one of the restaurants, and then it gets sold at a profit to the restaurant. That's what I'm doing. Actually, Chef is going to show me, and I'm going to finish cases of hot dogs with it. That is going to bounce.
Nice.
All fat.
Chili fat.
We're discussing
that.
We stopped thinking about what I'm throwing away here. But we do this, we don't do this for just because we got it for $2 a pound cheaper. Did this so you could see where the stuff comes from. That's the whole idea behind this.
It also helps illustrate the amount of waste.
That right? Crumbles.
It helps
like
think about
cheese.
Something beyond just the paper
feta
price.
Cheese. You cannot buy meat by price alone. You have to match up the trim specification as well as the quality. The trim specification can put you out of business if you're not careful.
times where you would not want to slip. It's going to be the same way when you're going out of pork loin. The blade of your knife has got to be on the bone, or you are cutting something that you don't need to be cutting into. Just like with the shank. You know, I wrote a lot of you about, you know, blade on the bone, blade on the bone. Extremely important. Bread is bread. If you leave it on the bone, well, it's not making you any money. You just lost it.
Restaurant. what does it look like to you? It's a ball skirt snake. That's correct. It's called a mock skirt snake. Okay? Can you see this in restaurants. You see this in retail establishments quite often.
And they'll just straight up label it skirt snake. They won't say false skirt snake.
They'll use it as a skirt.
It's going to call it skirt snake. So you're going to get $4, $5, $6 a pound for something that should be selling for $3 a pound or less. And they're called mock skirt snakes. In a little while, hopefully I'll be able to show you a real skirt snake. And you'll see a difference. Okay.
At least 20 minutes, yeah.
Yeah. I don't want to waste time during learning time just to trim this stuff out. This is just a little bit of knife experience, a little bit of knife in your hand. Anytime you have a knife in your hand, you're learning something. Yeah. I gotta leave the fan on. I know it's cold, but there's so much fat in here. It's just so greasy.
Doesn't give me a call.
I will.